now like to move on to the real substance of our webinar this afternoon and invite Dr. Donald Wright to lead us in the first presentation this afternoon on healthcare-associated infections. So, Don, I'll turn it over to you.
Thank you, Carter. Let me say it's a privilege to lead today's discussion on healthcare-associated infections. For those of us at the department that have worked very diligently on reducing these infections over the last several years, we are truly pleased to see that this is a focus area for Healthy People 2020, a new focus area. Next slide. Initially, I wanted to take just a minute and give you a brief overview of where we'd like to go over the next 90 minutes. Initially, I'm going to talk a little bit about healthcare-associated infections and give you an idea of the burden of this particular public health concern. From there, I want to talk about the National Quality Strategy and the Partnership for Patients and the intersection with those two initiatives and the reduction of healthcare-associated infections. This will be followed by an overview of HHS's initiative to reduce healthcare-associated infections. And from there, we'll move on in and discuss the Healthy People 2020 objectives of where we would like to be at the end of this decade. Certainly, we'll want to discuss the changing landscape that we've seen in the area of healthcare-associated infections over the last decade, and we'll hear from both the Center for Disease Control and the Agency for Healthcare Research and Quality during this part of the program. From there, we'll move on in and discuss some other federal resources and tools, and we have two presentations from outside groups that have had great success in reducing healthcare-associated infections in their particular institutions. We want to finish the presentation with some action steps or next steps moving forward, and despite that ambitious agenda, we hope to have time 10 to 15 minutes at the end of the presentations to take questions from their audience that can be submitted electronically. Next slide, please. I wanted to talk a little bit about the burden from healthcare-associated infections. It's been estimated that one out of every 20 patients hospitalized in a U.S. hospital will acquire a healthcare-associated infection. Next slide. We know if we use some data that was accumulated in 2002, we know that there are about 100,000 lives lost each and every year from a healthcare-associated infection. To gain some perspective on that number, that would be the equivalent of a 747 jet going down, crashing each and every day, 365 days a year. Next slide. I think it is helpful to compare the burden from this particular public health concern with some of the others that we address each and every year. As I mentioned, the deaths per year from healthcare-associated infections are thought to be about 100,000 per year based on 2002 data. If we look at those that have died from motor vehicle accidents, it's about 42,000. From breast cancer, about 40,000 every year. And from HIV/AIDS, around 17,000 each year. So clearly, this is a significant public health concern and worthy of consideration. Next slide. Not only is this issue important in human terms, which the data certainly supports that, I maintain that it's also important in economic terms. It's estimated that the healthcare-associated infections that we have are responsible for $28 to $33 billion in excess healthcare costs each and every year. Next slide. If we break that down by infection, every time there's a surgical site infection, it increases cost of that hospitalization around $21,000. For bloodstream infections, $16,000. Ventilator-associated pneumonia, $21,000. And a catheter-associated urinary tract infection, approximately $1,000. Next slide. So clearly, in human terms, this is a significant public health concern, and we also know from an economic perspective this is a very important issue to address. But there is good news. Studies have told us that many HIAIs are preventable. In fact, in the area of central line-associated bloodstream infections, implementation and close adherence to existing infection control practices will reduce these infections up to 70%. Next slide. I want to move at this time into two new initiatives that have been released from HHS. The first is the National Strategy for Quality Improvement in Healthcare, or better known as the National Quality Strategy. This particular strategy was mandated through the Affordable Care Act, and as most of you know, the Affordable Care Act seeks to increase access to high-quality, affordable healthcare for all Americans. Next slide. There are three major aims of the National Quality Strategy: better care, more affordable care, and healthy people in healthy communities. Next slide. Within that, there are seven different priority areas, and one of the priority areas is making care safer, or certainly addressing patient safety concerns, of which healthcare-associated infections is one. I think it's important to note that the Michigan Keystone Intensive Care Unit Project was enumerated in the National Quality Strategy under the making care safer component. Next slide. More recently, the department released an initiative entitled Partnerships for Patients, Better Care, and Lower Cost. This particular initiative was launched by Secretary Sebelius on April 12th of this year, and it's a public-private partnership to improve quality, safety, and affordability of health care for all Americans. It would result in potential savings of up to $35 billion, including $10 billion for Medicare. Next slide. There are two major goals of the Partnership for Patients, and many of you may have already heard of these. The first is keep patients from getting injured or sicker during their healthcare experience. More specifically, we were trying to decrease by 40% all preventable causes of hospital-acquired conditions. The second goal focuses on helping patients heal without complications. And our goal under this particular area is to reduce by 20% preventable complications during a transition from one care setting to another, and reducing all 30-day readmission rates to hospitals by 20%. Next slide. Under the area of preventing all or reducing all preventable harm in the hospital, we are focusing on nine specific areas to really benchmark our success in reducing preventable harm. And you'll notice on this slide, highlighted in yellow, are four healthcare-associated infections. So four of the nine areas that we will be monitoring moving forward to determine our success in reducing preventable harm will be the major causes of healthcare-associated infections in the healthcare setting, in the hospital setting.